Everyone, in this tutorial I am going to go through the go to statement. The go to statement is considered a harmful construct in most accounts of modern programming technology. It causes an unconditional jump to a labeled statement somewhere in the current program. The go to statements form has we use go to that line which begins with label. That line we have call it label, and label is colon and a statement, what we want to do in that statement. The example, simple example, is a while loop. While we get something from the prompt and put it in address X is 1. It means that you have entered a value. And in the while loop, when this condition is true, we are going inside the while loop. We are going to use a if statement. If x is negative, is lower than, less than 0.0, because x is a float and we have a long float, and if it is negative value, go to negative alert. Otherwise you are going to write the value of a squared x and the value of a squared 2x, and in negative alert we are going to print that negative value encountered. Okay, another example, we are going to run this example first in C. And we are going to make it beautiful, and this one is there, and this one I don't need. Yes, this one I don't need it. But while has if and print, and it must be in clammer. And the label, the negative alert, is beginning, and we put a colon and the expression or a statement. Now we are going to run to compile this one. Okay, we have used the variable before we declare it, float x. Now we are going to compile it again. It is okay. Now we are going to use a value 64.0, and it is LF. I am going to run it again. It is correct now, and I am noting 100. is carré, and I am going to use 81. It is correct, and we are going to use a minus value like minus 1 and a negative value encountered, and it jump out. Okay, the another example is if C equals get char, what you take it from the prompt is not new line, go to rep, and if it is if it is not new line, go to rep, and in rep you are going to print out that you are cute. If it is new line, it jump out and the program is end. I am going to use these codes in our program V, and I am going to declare a variable char C because we use it here, and this one must be single quote and this one must be there, and I don't need that clamp because it is only one statement inside the loop, and the rep is here. Now I am going to compile it and I am going to run it. I am going to use hello world, you are cute, and it is done, but I must use a new line, and I am going to take it again, and I am going to use word, and it is cute and it is okay. Okay, another thing I want to use it here is an for statement that I am going to declare int sum equals 0, and I am going to use for int I equal 1, I less than or equal 10, and I am going to use sum plus equal I and plus plus I. Now I'm going to use semicolon, empty statement inside the loop, and I am going to print f. The sum is 55 as we expected. Then you can use more. If I use sum equals 0 and I from 1, and I define I here, what is going to happen? Okay, and sum. Now we are going to see the result. and it is 55 as well. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you. Maybe I can check something if I use int here and put away that one. Now we are going to see. Okay, we cannot declare inside this one, only we use int sum and I, and I am going to compile. It is okay. I am going to execute or run, and it is correct. Okay, it is another way that use for loop with empty statement, and everything is here. You have defined sum, you have initialized sum 0 and initialized I 1, which is the loop variable, and while until I is less than 10, you are going to increment sum with I, and you are going to increment I with 1. Okay, and it was all in this tutorial. See you in next tutorial.